A bombshell 60 Minutes investigation has lifted the lid on how high-profile criminals have managed to infiltrate the Australian construction industry. For more, we're joined now by investigative journalist Nick McKenzie in Melbourne. Nick, thanks so much for your time this morning. Some really damning claims in your investigation last night. A lot of fear had prevented this from being exposed before. What triggered people to come forward?
I think people are utterly sick or upset of the way that organised crime, bullying, intimidation has become a normalised part of the construction sector thanks to some allegedly criminal dodgy elements within the CFMEU's construction wing. Mm. I mean, I've been overwhelmed by responses from small businesses, from small construction companies to say, finally, this is now out in the public, but in the industry, everyone knew about it.
Yeah.
And more importantly, within the ALP, it's also really well known. We'll be putting out tomorrow fresh evidence showing that some of the highest political officers in the land knew about this alleged criminality standover involving the CFMEU.
You know, Nick, I think that's the worst part about all of this, right? The troubling aspect is that these accusations that governments and others had turned a blind eye to this bullying and thuggish behaviour time and again. Why did they let it keep happening?
I did a story 10 years ago, which was a replica of the story we did last night, except it's gotten worse in that 10 years, and that's after a Royal Commission. I mean, ultimately, why this has been allowed to take hold in New South Wales, Victoria and Queensland especially, and to a lesser extent WA, it's a disgrace. And the question is this, why hasn't there been appropriate action from the authorities? So I think the police, state and federal, have been missing in action here. Now, they would say, hang on, it's not our business to be policing unions. Ultimately, it's a political question. So it's over to the Albanese government. What will they do? They flagged that they are open to action, but we've heard that before. At the moment, right now, the most powerful bloke, Setka's gone in Victoria, John Setka, the CFMEU, the most powerful bloke in the CFMEU in Victoria, we say took $200,000 allegedly in kickbacks from bosses. He is still running the union. The bloke running the new union in New South Wales is facing corruption allegations before the courts as we speak, still leading the union there. Mm. So this union, the construction union, cannot clean itself up.
You mentioned there, obviously, John Setka resigning in the face of this investigation on Friday ahead of your investigation being on 60 Minutes. But it's that thuggish, that standover behaviour that we heard last night that would send chills down the spines of so many out there.
Well, again, it's normalised in the construction sector in Victoria to get a call from Mick Gatto, an alleged long-time connected underworld figure, to sort out your union problems. We had a tape of him saying, I've got friends in the CFMEU. If I do things the right way, they look after me. We had video of CFMEU organisers, senior officials, threatening to very violently bash small business owners on a state government site in Victoria. We told the story of a young Indigenous worker who had a prescription drug overdose and died after facing what he told his mother was severe CFMEU standover tactics on, again, a state government job in Victoria. There's links to organised crime and companies backed by the union in New South Wales, again, getting state government work paid for by the New South Wales taxpayers. It's rampant. It's going on. We've put it on the table. And again, we look to the next phase of this. What will the response be? How do we curb this misbehaviour?
Absolutely. Everyone will be watching what Tony Burke does next. Thanks so much for your time, Nick. Appreciate it.
Welcome back to the show. Well, we're joined now by the Treasurer, Jim Chalmers, live from Canberra. Our Treasurer, good morning to you. Thanks for your time this morning. A bit happening. Should the CFMEU be deregistered, given the allegations against them? It's abhorrent.
Oh, of course it is, and that's why the Industrial Relations Minister, Tony Burke, is looking at all of the options, including that one, and he will take the necessary action. I think what we've seen in the revelations over the weekend and some of that good work by the journalists involved, I think we've seen some absolutely horrific behaviour. And we will do whatever is necessary to clean it up.
OK, so will you stop taking donations from them?
I think as Tony made clear yesterday and as I make clear again today, there are good reasons why ministers don't get involved in those sorts of decisions which are taken by party organisations. Our focus is on dealing with and addressing the issues that were raised in those stories over the weekend. I think if you take a step back for a moment, Carl, you know, overwhelmingly the trade union movement is a force for good in our society and in our economy, and union leaders, in my experience, are overwhelmingly good and decent people who want to get good outcomes for their members. And I don't think you could say either of those things about the CFMEU under John Setker. And so we will take whatever steps are necessary to clean it up.
Pressure is mounting on the federal government to clean up the construction union after a damning expose on 60 Minutes. Let's bring in Today Federal Politics reporter Liz Daniels. Liz, good morning. Explosive recordings have been aired.
Sarah, a pretty ugly insight into what's become one of the nation's most militant unions, the CFMEU. An undercover sting operation by 960 Minutes gathered evidence of a corruption scheme in which a self-styled fixer can be heard offering to bribe unionists to push certain builders onto lucrative taxpayer-funded projects. Have a listen.
There's a fee to get the EBA.
Yep.
I think the upfront fee is cash. But all you're going to do, I told you, pay the boys, make sure they're okay, and that's it. That's business. And everybody else.
Colourful boss of the CFMEU's Victorian branch, John Setker, resigned over the weekend ahead of that story going to air, and the federal government is now warning that if the union doesn't clean up its act, Sarah, it could be deregistered.
Thank you, Liz. All right, Angus, just very quickly, you may have seen those explosive allegations against the CFMEU yesterday on 60 Minutes. Do you think Tony Burke should deregister the union?
Well, of course, but actions speak louder than words, and the Labor Party's been very close to the CFMEU. They've been taking donations from the CFMEU for many years, and the behaviour we've seen on these construction sites is completely unacceptable. Labor has joined at the hip with the CFMEU, got rid of the ABCC, and last time I was on this program, we were just talking about the intimidation and threatening behaviour towards the head umpire. Of the AFL by the CFMEU. So Labor's got to get serious about this, stop taking their donations, deregister and re-establish the ABCC. That is the right thing to do.